Welcome, welcome to the Crochet Show with your host, Nikki. That's me. I am so excited to be here. We're going to talk about 5 crochet patterns that you can make in order to store your crochet hooks in. Now, of course, I love functional crochet patterns, which means they all have something with it that you can either learn from, or you have extra pockets, extra storage abilities, whatever you like. It always has something there that it seems to be brand new to at least a few of you. And I'm really excited for every single one of these patterns. One of these patterns is currently only a paid pattern. All other ones are 100% free for you to use and learn from. And most of them actually even come with video tutorials. So let's talk about the very first crochet pattern, and that is the crochet hook holder. Let me show you what I'm talking about. That is my only paid pattern that I'm going to talk about today. All the other ones are free. I got to tell you, the very last one is a very special treat because if you've never done something very special regarding that specific feature, you're going to learn something with it. Okay, the crochet hook holder pattern is a very intriguing one. It does kind of look like a book, kind of like, you know, the old fashioned style where there's like this thing in here, right? So kind of like an old journal or something. So you can open it up like so, and then you have all these slots right here to put your crochet hook. So here's one of my crochet hooks, like you slip it in. This guy right here has a multi-purpose. So it's technically to cover up your hook so that they won't fall down when you transport this thing, right? So that is cool. But you can also add some stitch markers in here or whatever you want to kind of pin. You can put some pins on here or make it kind of cool, whatever you like, right? So that's the idea behind this guy. These are all little pockets. You can make as many pockets as you like. As you can see, this is just sewn on. So you make as many as you like. Then right here is another pocket. And then right here is another pocket. Of course, this one with a little flap over. And then here's the cool feature. We all have, I truly believe most of you guys have some kind of old fashioned papers laying around with paper, with patterns on there. At least I usually print them out when I work on something. So right here's a gigantic pocket. I added a canvas here so you can take this out. This is not sewn in or anything. So there has more stability for the entire project. And then you can put papers in there. I mean, look how big this is. You can literally add so much to this pocket, right? And still be able to close it with the hooks in here. I mean, that is so cool. And then it just simply closes up like this, right? You just push it through here. You can add whatever you like over here, right? It can be a magnet or something, you know, and then you close it up. So cool. So this is called the crochet hook holder pattern, and it's available on my website. The next pattern actually is brand new, and I'm really excited about it because this pattern, you don't need any sewing. So let me show you what I'm actually talking about. Okay, it is called the crochet hook case. So I made it different. The first one is the crochet hook holder, and then the second one is case because it has a zipper. Okay, here it is. It's my brand new pattern. It's a free crochet pattern. It comes with a video tutorial that shows you the entire assembly of this crochet hook case. So first of all, it comes over here, right, with a little pocket, right? It uses the linked crochet stitches. This is actually a linked double crochet. As you can see, it fits scissors, and you can, there's room for like a measuring tape or whatever you like to put in there. And yes, this is not sewn on. This is literally hot glued on right here. So this is like a U shape, right? And then over here, hot glue. And as you can see, this is actually quite stable. So I know, how in the world is this like this? Okay, so let me show you. So right here, some fabric, okay? Simply cut it with some scissors, right? And there is some canvas, the same canvas, the plastic canvas that you just saw me hold up. It's behind here, little pieces of it. Again, hot glued on. And yes, there is a zipper all the way around. Again, hot glued on. I have the video for it, so don't you worry. And then here's the cool feature on this. So yes, of course it has here pockets, all again, hot glued, nothing sewn, hot glued, right? You have multiple pockets here. You can add as many pockets as you like. Link crochet for both of these, okay? And here's just a cool feature. Okay, so it is a pocket that you can kind of open like this, right? So you can add your papers in, as you can see. You can also use it to add a notepad in from the top down, right? So you kind of tuck it in and hang it over, if that makes sense. You can also use it for a small agenda going in this direction, right? So, and then hang it over so you can take notes, right? So, and this guy right here is simply that you can pull so that everything stays in place, as you can see, right? And then you can just tie it up over here, wrap it around, or whatever you like. Again, hot glued. Really cool. No sewing here. I think the only sewing I did was weaving in my ends and these two buttons, okay? And as you can see, it has a zipper, right? So there you go. It has a zipper all the way around. This is single crochet. It's the only single crochet part here. It's a dark pink. Everything else that's light pink is crochet. As you can see, there is not a lot of crochet. Here, this, again, you can put pins on there. You can put stitch markers, your tapestry needle, push them through. So you have them ready to go whenever you need them. Okay, so the next three patterns, I actually don't have the originals anymore, but I have pictures of them. So I'm gonna show you. So we have, the next one is the Tunisian smock stitch. So here it is. This is the Tunisian smock stitch pouch, okay. So it uses the smock stitch, the Tunisian smock stitch. So it has a video tutorial with it. So you learn how to do this, right? And as you can see, I added a pouch inside, like a fabric. You see, actually it's per se, if I be honest, it's not fabric, it's felt. And I added a zipper with it. And believe it or not, I have a video tutorial to show you exactly how to do that. So again, that is a free pattern. And as you can see, you can store quite a bit in there. It is a cute little pouch. You can transport wherever you like. And I actually kind of like the idea of the Tunisian smock stitch because again, I love things that are multi-purpose. You can see it has little kind of loops there, right? It looks like a honeycomb, but you can kind of put your finger through it. And that allows you to kind of attach something like a stitch marker or something, right? Or pins or whatever you like. So you have them ready to go. So don't think it's just for the beauty of it. It has a functionality too, which I absolutely love. And so there's a link in the description. And if you scroll down, all the links are right there for all the patterns, okay? So let me show you the next one. The next one, number four, is the snowflake tapestry pouch. Oh, that's a pretty one. It looks like this, okay? And it's absolutely cute. And yes, it also has a zipper on there. So that comes with a tutorial as well. I said earlier, I have four free patterns. I don't remember if this one is free or not. All of the patterns I show you come with some kind of PDF that you can purchase. The combination of using white yarn with variegated yarn makes such a gorgeous picture in the end. So it has that snowflake with some beautiful goodness around. Absolutely love it. And so it uses the single crochet in the back loop only as a tapestry combination where you carry your yarn with it. It is so beautiful. I absolutely love it. And yes, as I said, it comes with a zipper. It's a gorgeous little pattern and I highly recommend you check it out. So if you've never done tapestry, this is your pattern that you might want to try out. Okay. And then we have number five. So guys, number five is actually a very easy pattern. So if you've never done anything like this, including zippers in crochet, I would recommend this one as your very first pattern. So it's called the Easy Crochet Zipper Pouch, okay? So it looks like this. So what did I do? I used pretty much linked crochet on the pouch itself, but to make it really cool, what I actually did is I made the pouch with a zipper first, and then I crocheted around it and then finished it up on the bottom. So you can literally at this point control how big your pouch is going to be, which is kind of cool, right? So you make the inside with the zipper first. Again, there's a tutorial for it. And then you literally work your way around it to fill up the outside part of it, which is so cool. So if your lining is much bigger than mine, well, you just add a little bit more crochet around it, right? So you can see that every single one of these patterns has something special to it. So if you've never heard about about link crochet, you got to check that one out. I have multiple tutorials and tips and tricks articles for you. They're 100% free, including videos where I teach you step by step what that is, how you can use it. Link crochet is such a cool feature. Like, it has these the combination of normal crochet with Tunisian crochet together, right? It's like the beginning stage of Tunisian crochet. So you remove kind of the gaps between the stitches and make it absolutely stunning with it. It is so, so cool. So if you want to try that out, I would highly recommend starting with something small, such as this pouch, just to try out how linked crochet works. As I said, even the second pattern that I showed has linked crochet in it. So you can see I love linked crochet. So there might be something coming down the road in the near future. Who knows? All of these patterns are, by the way, also in the Crochet Club membership. So that is pretty much my PDF vault. And so if you have access to my membership, you have access to all of my patterns in a vault, including extra tutorials, support, and fun little lives and weekly, their weekly and monthly get-togethers, kind of, so we all see each other and have fun. I hope you love the patterns, and I hope to see you guys next time. And be sure to always like, comment, and share these videos, because they help me create more amazing things for you. I hope to see you next time. Until then, bye!